Yo, welcome to another video, guys. Today we're gonna talk about artifacts. I know, guys, I understand it's tedious, it sucks, farming them sucks. You don't know which ones are good, you don't know which ones are bad. What the hell should I do? Then on top of that, you've got to manage all of it. You don't know that Perna's an HP monster, you didn't know Balanus was a defense based monster. So this is not going to be perfect. I'm just going to give you some of my tips that I use to decide how I do my artifact management. Now, we are on the alt because I recently started farming artifacts on it. So hopefully you guys will be able to relate to this. But we're going to start right here, guys. So support, we're only going to take a look at the new ones that we got. All right. So I kept this one, right? Okay. So let's power it up. This is normally what I would do. So we power it up. I didn't even look at what it had, right? I already kept it. So it's got attack increasing effect, skill 3 accuracy, and speed plus proportionate to lost HP. It's also defense as the main stat, right? So here, right off the bat, what am I looking for? The first thing that comes to mind is maybe a Fran, right? Will this be better than what I have on Fran? And this is just because of the attack increasing effect, right? And now we've got a roll into skill 3 accuracy. So what does that tell me? Maybe an Annabelle, right? Well, let me show you how you would figure out who this would probably be best for. That might be good for nobody. So you would go to collection, go to search, and monster type, support, right? We've got attack increasing effect, right? So let's see, does any support unit that increase attack, let's take a look. A support unit that increases attack and also needs skill 3 accuracy. Oh my god, look at that, Geogon. Oh my god, of course. That could be pretty good for him. Not bad. Here we go, Bastet. She does not need skill 3 accuracy though. He doesn't need skill 3 accuracy, neither does the Megan. See, neither do these two. And nobody here really needs skill 3 accuracy. There we go. This one definitely does. So there we go. Actually, I think the best suitors for this would be the Corona and probably the Geogun, right? Corona and Geogun. So there you go. That's one that we knocked off. And really kind of just shows you who it's best for. Now we've got another one. We're gonna do the same thing. So we've got same thing, attack increasing effect, skill 3 recovery, and skill 3 crit damage. So depending on what it rolls, then we can do the same thing and kind of figure out who it's gonna be for. If we skip the skill 3 recovery, then hey, same thing, maybe the Geogun, right? I do have both Corona and the Geogun, so maybe I just upgraded those two artifacts right there. Let's see what it dodges. I did want to show you. Okay, so it didn't dodge anything, right? So is there anyone that does damage and needs skill 3 recovery? So we take a look, search, same thing, support. And this time, because we did hit the recovery, we want to make sure that we click recover HP. So skill 3 recovery, skill 3 crit damage. Is there anyone? I guess I think she does, right? Remove some harmful effects. Never mind, not her. So after looking closely, guys, I believe it's just the Chi-Chi that would benefit from this. She does damage and recovers HP. Now I'm personally not gonna build it, so can actually toss this. I think I can toss it because on top of that, I would need to run something for sure that was going to be increasing the attack on it. All right, so we've got another one here. It is an HP artifact and it's got skill 3 crit damage, additional damage by HP, and attack plus proportionate to lost HP. So we're going to need to look for someone that does something on their skill 3 that you would build on crit damage, possibly scales off of HP, or actually, wow, that's not bad at all. So HP artifact, right? So we've got skill 3 crit damage, attack plus proportion to lost HP, and additional damage by HP. So we take a look, we go to HP, and we search. All right, so fire units, oh my god, you know, there's quite a few. Man, you know, you might be surprised that Shiwu is an HP monster. This guy for sure, this thing wrecks. He can definitely benefit off additional damage by his HP. He has multi-hits, so he would be a great, great candidate. Looky. Yes, who? Bulldozer. Skill 3 crit damage, 17%. He is an HP monster. Honestly, that when I saw that artifact, Bulldozer did not jump off the table for me. And guess what? The main stat on that artifact is defense. So guess who just got an upgrade? He actually scales off attack as well. So I just got a brand new artifact for the Dozer. I'm actually going to go throw it on. I'm pretty sure it's better than what... Never mind. He didn't have any. Like I said, I just started doing these. So I'll take this to plus 12. And now that I know it landed on him, I'll be able to then... Whatever that fourth substat is going to be, we can actually try to gem it off and get something else. Which we're going to do right now. Let's skip to plus 12. There we go, and guess what? It actually got skill 1 crit damage on top of it. So I may actually not even need to do anything to this. So I don't have that many of these conversion stones, so I'm going to leave it as is for now. But because I'm going to start farming a lot more artifacts, I will have more of these on this account, and then I can actually, you know, change that out. Maybe go with crit damage as the HP is good, maybe. To kind of double dip on the skill 3 crit damage. There you go. That was a very, very nice Dozer rune. I kind of just, because the main stat was defense, I didn't even keep looking because I knew he needed an artifact, and that was just kind of perfect for him. Now we've got an attack one here. Now the main stat is HP. For the most part, I think on your attack artifacts, HP and attack is the main stat, should be usually the what you want to aim for. Now, we've got skill 2 crit damage. We just hit attack increasing effect. And we've got crit damage up to 5% as the enemy's HP condition is good. So right off the bat, we already hit attack increasing effect and the crit damage while good. Just a skill 2 crit damage, you know, my mind just straight, you know, skill 2 Nukers, Kali, maybe the Chimera, but we're gonna take a look and see which one who it might be good for. As of right now though, this definitely looks like a Kali rune. That's crit damage for the Kali S2. We've got a, you know, Kali buffs its own attack and 15%. Usually when you're gonna nuke, they're still pretty high in HP. So for sure right now this looks like a Kali rune, but you can always double check. So we would go to attack type, and let's just see who increases attack. Hey, actually, possibly you can go with an Antares, right? You can go with an Antares if you wanted to. Trevor as well, skill 2. I didn't even think about that. See, we can go with this guy. This guy does damage with his S2. He buffs his own attack. So as you can see, there's definitely a few units, and this is what I use to gauge who I put these artifacts on. Now, of course, had we hit skill 2 crit damage, then maybe we don't even need to check this. We would just kind of look through our box and our attack type monsters and see who does some heavy, heavy damage with the S2 that we are already going to be running with an attack buff. Now, how do you manage the water, wind, and light, and dark, and all that? You want to have all the fire units that you actually use out. And then you kind of just, okay, let's take a look. Okay, we've got a legend one. You will roll it, obviously. It'll be easier for you, because look, you can even scroll while that thing's on there. You can just kind of look right here. Boom, boom. And actually, you know what? Dozer might kind of benefit from this, possibly. If we were to get something else, maybe some crit damage while the HP condition is good, or something along those lines, right? So I don't have the Shaman Fae out because I don't use it too much, but if he jumped out at me when I saw this artifact, then I would just roll it and throw it on him. So that's kind of how I figure the attribute artifacts out. So there you go, guys. I hope this helped even just a little bit. If you're still watching, do me a favor, man. I could really use your help with subscribers. Definitely slap that like button for the YouTube algorithm. And guys, you will get better at managing your artifacts. You didn't know? Yeah, you know. You know?